Let me start off by saying this road trip was incredible. I got hit in the middle of the night with a burst of energy. Despite me being in class on Zoom, I said, you know what? Let me throw the bags in the trailer. I'm ready to roll. I used to love MTV Cribs, so I guess this is my chance. Welcome to the backseat of the truck. You know, we made a bed. We got the little refrigerator as our kitchen.
You're still drawing.
This class is on market research. Remember that.
But you need to figure out.
So this drive is about 14 hours. It's not nothing new. I've done this plenty of times. Driven to Miami, driven to Mississippi, Atlanta, the whole nine. Let's get ready for it, right? So we stop at the gas station, only to find out that our average gas mileage is 6.8 miles. I should have known right there that that was going to be an issue, but whatever. I'm ready for the road. I think I'm about to change my name from Supreme to Big Sexy. This time it's the next morning. We done switched a couple of times. We actually filled up the gas tank 10 times at $85 a gallon. How do I know? I keep track. But we made it to Florida. Since we're here, I have the great idea. We might as well stop and see some people I haven't seen in a long time. Made some calls for Jacksonville, Orlando, Kissimmee, Tampa. But by this time, I'm delusional on the road, so I just start singing. So then I think, since we're already down here, we might as well check the distance between Naples and Miami. What can happen, right? We make it all the way to Kissimmee, and I just keep getting caught at this electronic gate. But whatever, I'm not mad. My cousin Jamil's a chef, and he cooked for us.
I want to see an alligator.
Y'all know how adamant I am about things I want. So the next morning, I'm up, I'm walking around the neighborhood, and I cannot find an alligator. Man, so whatever. At this point, I got an attitude because I couldn't find one. So I'm just ready to get in the car and drive over to Tampa. Yes, I looked for one the entire way there. I am not playing. So we make it across to Ybor City in Tampa to stop for breakfast. What's the first thing we see? Man, chickens, not no alligator. Chickens. Chasing chickens. You got your chicken? Yeah. Luckily, my sis Shanae stopped out.
Nope.
Took us out to breakfast. And this restaurant we've been to at least twice. But I can't remember the name of it. But if you're ever there, you should go. Another few hours on the road. And lo and behold, we're finally in Naples. The best part about being a creative is that you have so many creative friends. On the road, we're listening to Tia Reid's unreleased new single. After more gas, no gators, we finally make it to our check-in, Naples Picasso. Special thank you for these welcome gifts. Between the artwork and the arrangements in here, I had to support. I like to do that everywhere that I go. So I ended up getting this floral arrangement made for Erica after driving with me for the past 18 hours. Let's see how she likes them. Next, we made our way over to Fifth Ave. It came highly recommended. We went over to quite a few different restaurants. We people watched and made our way over to the beach.
It's just so.
The type of homes that I got the chance to see were just immaculate, man. Massive. And we made it to the beach before sunset. That was the goal of the day. When we left Tampa, we said we gotta catch the sunset. After catching a few more galleries for the evening, we decided to call it a night. After spending triple the gas budget for the entire trip, just going, I say, yo, man, we sleeping in the car. But somebody wasn't having that. By this time, it's Friday morning, the day of the setup, and the boss of bosses is giving me a call wondering where I am and how long it's going to take me to get home. I swear, this kid is hilarious. You can guess, still no gators. I'm getting irritated. Plus, I didn't properly pack, so I had to make a Target run, buying all sorts of stuff that I really didn't want to buy. But whatever.
Transitions. We're here.
Well, you can't go wrong with a little R&R. Now, it's time to get to work. We're about to start unpacking, unloading, and setting up. What could go wrong, right? At least that's what I thought. At least I had help, right? Truthfully, the setup was a breeze. I practiced this so many times with Poncho that I was ready for it. I even instructed Erica on the spot. So here we are setting up the tent. Next, we do the display walls, lining them up, securing them. And then next, we get to the display of the art. And here's where I mention marketing, where you understand your customer. You bring certain color schemes. You bring certain sizes because you know how the houses are. You know about the disposable income in the area. You factor all of these things into the overall setup or what you bring for the show. After setup, we both lie and say we're not tired. So we go out to dinner in Bonita Springs. And we actually get to experience this live performance by these two sisters. I gotta find their names. Don't remember off the top of my head. But I really liked what they were singing and how they sung. Of course, you can't end the night unless you have a little bit of fun. So here we are racing down the street. And of course, I won. You know who cheated. I'm undefeated out here. But I had a ball. All right, it's the day of the show. And here's where things started to get a little bit weird. Now, I understand that I sell art. Art is a commodity. It's a like it or love it kind of thing. It's not necessarily a necessity. So there's a lot of things to factor in. So originally with my setup, I had a banner out front and I was standing on the inside. And after about 2 hours, I noticed that people were only standing from about 15 feet away, taking pictures and continue walking. So to make it more inviting, I thought, why don't I just remove the banner? People started coming closer to the tent, but once they realized that I was inside, they would not come in. This is where it turned into somewhat of a social experiment. So instead of being inside the booth, I set up a chair directly across, just as you see in the image. And people started to go inside of it. They started taking pictures. I had some people actually get on the phone and call someone over. I heard them say that they wanted it, what room that they saw it, visualized it in. The price point was comfortable for them. It was only, it's only such and such price. At that point, I go to introduce myself and I lie to you not. They stare at me in my face and just walk out of my booth. At this point, we're about 3 or so hours in and Erica returns. And I have her actually go in my booth and be my sales rep. Do you know that there were plenty of people that went in, but there were 2 definitive sales. I'm talking people with their card out, were in the POS, they're ready to purchase and take the piece away. They ask her who's the artist. She either points to me or invites me to come over and introduce myself. And in both instances, the people walk out of the booth. At this point, I'm 10 karat hot. So I take her advice, I go for a walk, and I call on my support system. So I call my mentor, Poncho. I call my coach, Scott. I call my best friend, Alita. And then I call my Aunt V. Each of them give me different tactics on how to handle the situation and come back to it the next day, you know, with my chin up and chest out.
Hey, Dad,
as the day wrapped up, I received this video from my son saying he was in New York with my mom. Man, it was like a breath of fresh air. This gave me all the motivation I needed to see it through. Going back to the beach, I really had a moment to reflect, more so a moment of clarity. The work that people love is an extension of the experiences that made me into who I am. And me going to this show, taking down all of my images just to appeal to someone for a sale, that wasn't me. My work is meant for those who stand out in any room, that leave an impact wherever they go. This experience gave me a deeper appreciation for Baltimore and its cultural scene. I mean, it's so diverse. They encourage collaboration, they encourage partnership, and they really make things happen. I was really looking forward to getting back home after this. I guess you could say that day two went better. I mean, I did get a compliment by a guy, and he said, nice work. So I asked him if I could tell him a little bit more about myself or hand him like a flyer. And his reply was, absolutely not. So I took that on the chin, you know, sat, and here's what most of the day looked like. Until my homie Thomas showed up all the way from Baltimore.
We in here, okay?
And this just made my day. And by the way, here's a frog, but still no gate. All right, it's the next morning. I am so excited to get back to civilization. I'm ready to do this 2-hour drive over to Miami to the D.A. Dorsey house. On the way, I mean, you know I'm still looking for gators. We actually go to one of these little moat thingy things and yeah, man. Continue to drive, get all the way, check out these gardens. We're over in Overtown. It's a historically black community in downtown Miami. We walk around the block and I end up seeing the Longshoremen ILA.
I'm coming down.
Miami. Next, I had the opportunity of stopping by the D.A. Dorsey house. D.A. Dorsey was Miami's first black millionaire who became one through real estate. The current exhibition that's in the home is On the Bandwagon, The Power of the Pen. It's an exhibition on banned books by the Black Archives and Muse. This was honestly a privilege to sit here with all this literature and truly reflect not only on my experiences, but the history of the state. If you aren't aware, a few years back, Florida actually banned certain courses related to black history. And this was just a reminder of where I was and why I was experiencing what I was experiencing. It's money messing with their mouth. The exhibition, we decided to keep it local. We went over to Lil Greenhouse Grill and had the best food we had in a while. This was followed by an amazing conversation on the cultural climate of Florida, Miami-Dade County specifically, with Bart, Melissa, and Erica. Next, we went over to Wynwood to check out some different murals. After all that driving, it was time for some R&R. We found a rooftop pool, decided to just kick back for a little bit. I'm just blown away we did all of that with a trailer full of art. I'm just grateful. Everything that's been sent to destroy me or break my character has failed so far, and it's gonna continue to. And despite all of these negative experiences, I realized that I'm actually living my ancestors' wildest dreams. So I had to jump back on and grab some more tacos before we get back on the road. Talking Tacos was the spot. Food was amazing. So I know I already told y'all about the 6 miles per gallons that we had driving down due to the weight of the trailer, this, that, and the third. So we headed home. We find this shortcut called Florida Turnpike. We hop on this thing. It's supposed to get us there, shave off a little bit of time. Man, when we get on there, exit after exit after exit was closed until you get all the way to the end. So there was nowhere to stop for gas. Bro, I lied to you not. I get out of the car after running. No, matter of fact, let me slow down. I run out of gas, and it tells me that I would have to drive 30 minutes up the highway, off of an exit, and back down the highway to get to the nearest exit to get gas. I'm not doing that. So despite the road being closed, I hop out of the car. I run across the grass patch. I run about a half mile up the highway till I see this road crew. I go talk to them, to their foreman. I ask them, like, yo, listen, this is where I'm at. This is where I'm trying to get to. Can y'all help? They say, absolutely not. You gotta walk to the gas station. Now, mind you, I'm in slippers, but I'm a run. I'm running to the, nothing gonna stop me. I'm running to the gas station. I go get some gas. These dudes meet me at the gas station and was like, oh man, we felt bad after seeing you go the rest of the way. We figured that we would move the barrier and let you drive up the highway to bring your car to the gas station. By this time, my dogs are barking. I'm out of breath. I'm pissed off, but you know what? Let me just shut up because they are about to give me a ride, right? So this is Tim. And Tim holds it down, man. He moves the barrier. He tells everybody under him what we're going to do. They bring the gas can back over for me. They felt bad. Next thing you know, I drive about 14 more hours. I'm back in Baltimore. Time to get busy on this latest commission. I got to turn it into my client by Monday. And I'm just coming with a whole lot of new experiences. So all in all, this was a 10 out of 10 experience. I learned a lot of character development. Would I go to that show again? Maybe not.